Hi friends, welcome to this particular topic on measurement skills today. Measurement skills is an important topic if you are especially a data science professional dealing with different kinds of data. Measurement is one of the very important concepts that you need to master. To understand the data, we need to often, consider what is the scale on which the data is measured. Right, and that brings us to this concept of measurement skills, because often we need to aggregate data in some way. Often we need to manipulate data in a certain way. For example, if your data is continuous in nature, you would be able to apply a certain kind of technique to it. If it's not continuous, if it's on the other hand discrete in nature, you might have to apply a certain other technique. So knowing about the measurement scales of your data is really critical if you are doing any analysis on data. Now let us look at what are the broad measurement scales that we have. The first one is a nominal measurement scale. What we say here is that if you are looking at a qualitative classification and we are not able to rank order or quantify, for example, we cannot say or use the term like X is more than or less than Y, then we are looking at nominal variables. Examples would be things like gender, race, color, city. We cannot really order them. On the other hand, we have variables which can be also called ordinal, and here it allows us to rank order the variables in a way so that we can say X is less or more than Y. However, ordinal variables do not give us insight about the magnitudes. For example, we cannot say how much more is X compared to Y. For example, if you are looking at the upper middle class and trying to say that, upper middle class as a section of the population is 10% or 20% higher than the middle class, we cannot really come up with a conclusion like that. So those kind of variables where we have a clear segmentation among the different groups in a population is kind of ordinal. Not really measure how much more or less it is compared to anything else. One other measurement scale is the interval scale, which not only allows us to rank order the items that we are trying to measure, but it also allows us to quantify and compare the differences among the two or multiple variables that we are looking at. An example would be temperature. If we are measuring temperature in degrees or Fahrenheit, we could easily compare the two numbers. For example, we can say 30 degrees is less than 50 degrees in the terms of temperature. One interesting measurement scale here is the ratio scale. In addition to all the properties of the interval variables that we have seen above, what differentiates a ratio scale is that there is an identifiable absolute zero point. What this means is that we have a natural zero that we are looking at. So this allows us for statements like X is 2 times more than Y. When we say that, what we are trying to mean is that we are looking at a natural zero, which on the scale of which these two variables are being measured. So imagine if you are looking at X and Y, imagine you are trying to compare numbers which have the same denominator. So X divided by 1 is 2 times greater than Y divided by 1. That's your implicit assumption when you are trying to compare the two variables. And this is only possible if you have the same scale or the same origin for the two variables that you are looking at. And this is very important, especially when we are, this kind of concepts on measurement skills is really handy and useful, especially when we are, trying to aggregate certain information. For example, if you are looking at a count variable, let's say we are looking at the transactions that a customer is making to a store and we want to aggregate that kind of information, there would be a certain technique to use that. We cannot use sum to aggregate. So again, if you're looking at sales, maybe then we could use a sum of sales in case we are trying to find out the total sales. So the concept of aggregating, when to use the average, when to use a max, when to use a sum, depends on what kind of variables we are trying to look at and what kind of variables we are trying to aggregate, right? So this is an important concept, guys, and this will be really handy for all of you if you are looking at different kinds of data and dealing with different kinds of variables. So that's all that we had to discuss today. Hope you have learned something new. Don't forget to click on the bell icon and subscribe button to stay updated about our new classes and sessions. Stay tuned. We will catch up.